Yeah, hi there. These comments are for Adriana. This is Michael, the founder, owner, and the materials writer for the 7-Step System to pass the 12-4 IBT. And you have put together a whole bunch of recordings at my website. And you're one of my paying subscribers. Also, you paid for the additional service to have more specific tutoring and instructions regarding your pronunciation and your speaking as it relates to the TOEFL. All right, let's take a look at your first of, it looks like, five different responses that you recorded at my Voxipot group. I'll start with the first one. It says, meet and greet Adriana, your Vegas student.
Hi, Michael. This is Adriana. I want to tell you that I took the exam on September 29. I failed again, unfortunately for me. I got only a 22 in speaking.
Okay, so you had 22 points on the speaking part of the test.
Really concerned about. I don't know what exactly I have to do in order to improve my speech. I will keep going with the lessons from your website.
Keep
it
up.
And I will send you most of the time three speaking essays and one writing essays to give me a feedback.
Okay. And we'll say, to give me feedback, usually we don't say a feedback. Feedback is an uncount noun, doesn't need that article before it.
And I will send some of the essays that you already gave me a feedback, but the ones that you gave me a lower grade, I will do it again.
Okay. Now, if you like, what you can also consider, if you want to do some new independent or integrated writing practice test, you can, as long as you go to the, wherever the practice test is, you can post the new question in there so I can see it, and then I can grade the writing based on that new prompt you put in there, not the original one that's on that particular page. So you can do that if you like.
And we'll see how it's gonna work. Pretty much, I don't know exactly what I can do to improve more. I will keep going with two reasons and two examples and the independent one, because for sure it's mandatory. My experience is this. I got a 24 when I could use two reasons and two examples, and I used the introduction and the conclusion when was possible. Anyway, we keep in touch, and I will keep going with all of my study plan, and with your help, maybe I will get it.
Okay, remember, too, be careful about the T consonant. You want to pronounce that sound to keep in touch. Make sure you produce that with enough air.
The test was kind of okay. I got the passing score, even in the writing. I got the 24. Even if the independent writing was kind of strange subject, the topic was not so easy. But the integrated one was the one which helped me pretty much. I will send a writing essay for independent to check for me with.
Okay, sounds good.
That topic. Thank you. Have a good day.
All right. You too. Okay, now let's get started with four different independent speaking tests.
Personally speaking, the game which I enjoy playing is soccer. This game lasts 90 minutes. It consists of two different teams. Each team has 11 players. And I enjoy playing this game because I'm very confident as a player and it's useful for my health. I'll start by saying that I have been playing soccer for 20 years. As a result, I know this game like the back of my hand, which makes me very confident as a team player. Additionally, I enjoy playing soccer because it's useful for my head. For instance, during the game I have to run for 90 minutes, and this is a very good workout, which helps me to keep in a very good physical and psychological conditioning, which is why I really enjoy playing soccer.
All right, let's go back and listen to it a little bit closer this time. Now, I think you might get into trouble here because it looks like there's two parts of the question. The first part of the question says, describe the game, And then it says, explain why you like this game. So I think you've explained why you like it, but I'm not sure that you have described the game. That might get you into trouble with this one. Let's see what you say.
Personally speaking, the game which I enjoy playing is soccer. This game lasts 90 minutes. It consists of two different teams. Each team has 11 players.
Okay, there it is. You're describing kind of a little bit, so you are answering the first part of the question.
And I enjoy playing this game because I'm very...
So then you get into the second part of the question, which is, I enjoy playing this game.
Confident as a player, and it's useful for my health.
So I'm confident as a player, and it is useful for my health.
I'll start by saying that I have been playing soccer for 20 years. As a result, I know this game like the back of my hand, which makes me very confident as a team player.
Okay, so after you describe the game, you gave kind of a forecast statement to explain 2 points about why you think it's important, so I can follow your organization.
Additionally, I enjoy playing soccer because it's useful for my health. For instance, during the game I have to run for 90 minutes, and this is a very good workout which helps me to keep in a very good physical and psychological conditioning, which is why I really enjoy playing soccer.
Well, that's, to me, a pretty good speaking task. So you've answered both parts of the question. You have a clear pattern of organization. You're giving appropriate details to help support your generalizations. Your speaking speed was pretty good. I didn't notice any major problems in pronunciation, so that was also good. So I think you're at least 24 to 26 points out of 30 on this one. It was 3.16 to 3.33. That's a score I would give you based on your response right now. All right, let's keep going. Let's go to your second one. So this one, the second one is, it says independent speaking 5, and you gave 19 on this one. I've done another one, so you're trying to score a little higher on this one, it looks like.
Without any doubt, my mother is the most important person in my family.
Okay, so who is... Describe a person important in your life, and why is the person important to you?
Because she always inspires me, and she provides love and support to my siblings and me. My mother is a pretty blonde lady with blue eyes. She is beautiful not only in the outside, but in the inside as well.
Okay, so you're taking some time right now to give a physical description of your mom.
Start by saying that my mother...
Now, I'll start by saying that I would not use that every time. You might say first, or say something like this: in addition to my mom being really beautiful, you know, she's also very important to me, or something like that.
The breadwinner, and she inspires me by the power of example. For instance, while I was growing up.
I would say for in, not instance, but for instance, instance.
She worked as a nurse. As a result, I decided a few years ago to follow a healthcare profession. Additionally, my mother always supports me, and she encourages me.
So my mother supports me and encourages me. Maybe a little bit of pronunciation problem with that word. Let's go back.
Supports me, and she encourages me.
You want to say encourages, encourages. So you're kind of missing that syllable at the very end of that word.
For example, when I decided to leave my home country, she was worried, but she told me to follow my heart, and she gave me positive encouragement to pursue my dream.
So I would say positive encouragement to follow my dream. I wouldn't use encouragements, plural, on that word. I think it's kind of like, usually we use that, he gave me encouragement. It's kind of like an uncount noun. So that is a little bit of a problem in your speech with, I think, count nouns and uncount nouns, Adriana. You're not always sure whether or not you want to put an S on them. Obviously, with count nouns, if they're plural, put S on them. But if they're uncount nouns, don't put S on those words.
Without any doubt, my mother, while I was growing up, she worked as a nurse. As a result, I decided a few years ago to follow a healthcare profession. Additionally, my mother always supports me and she encourages me. For example, when I decided to leave my home country, she was worried, but she told me to follow my heart and she gave me positive encouragements to pursue my dream.
Okay, so let's stop right there. So this one, I'm going to score this one a little bit lower, between 23 and 24 points. So you, I think this one, you're obviously doing better than you did last time, but you do have some minor problems with your delivery and your language use a little bit with this one. So I'll put you 3.0 to 3.16 out of 4, or between 23 and 24 points out of 30. All right, let's go to the next one. The next one, I think, is your third speaking task that you're doing. It says, which book have you read that you would recommend to others? Now, you said, which book have you read that you would recommend it to others, but be careful. Because you're putting, once you put that in there, that replaces book. You don't need to use the pronoun it. Let's think about it this way. You might say, which book have you read? Which book would you recommend to others? So that replaces the word book. So there's no need for that pronoun. Okay, here we go.
In my estimation, a book that I read and I would like to recommend it to others is Around the World in 80 Days by Jules Verne.
All right, so you name the book and you name the author. Wow, you thought of that?
But a couple of reasons which makes me recommend this book. First of all, it's a classic book. The story sets itself in the middle of 19th century.
Okay, you're having some trouble there. In the middle of the 19th century. So you're having some intelligibility problems between about 12 and 16 seconds of your response.
And describes exotic adventures around the world.
That and describes, that's a little bit disruptive. That's an unnecessary kind of pause.
Story sets itself in the middle of 19th century and describes exotic adventures around the world from London to San Francisco.
That was pretty good. So you're talking a little bit about why you like the book.
Second of all, as its main subject, traveling. For example, when I read...
No, that's killing you there. No. Secondly, I recommend this book because... Or another reason why I recommend the book is, so let's go back to that. When you get to the next point, be specific. Take the idea, connect it back to the speaking task. It needs to be clear what this second point is connected to. Your whole purpose is to explain why you would recommend this book to other people. So keep the different topics and the different responses or the parts of your speech organized around that purpose.
Second of all, as its main subject, traveling. For example, when...
See, that's going to kill you right there. Be careful about that. Don't speak in fragments. You want to use subjects and verbs in that.
I read it a few years ago. I understood the meaning of international traveling. The more we experience other cultures, the more we understand about ourselves and our place in the world.
That was pretty good. So you're kind of talking about what you learned from the book.
Just to say that is that kind of book which you cannot put down once you've laid your eyes on its page.
Okay, I'm going to say I don't think you're going to do that well on this one. I'm going to put you at 23 points out of 30, 3.0 out of 4. So you need to make sure the different parts of the speech are connecting back to the purpose of the speech. You did have some delivery problems in certain parts of this speech that I think would bring your score down a little bit, right? Okay, let's move on. Let's go to the next one. So we got to the book. Now the next one is watch the news on television or read in the newspaper. It looks like you redid this one. You said the word that gave you trouble, me trouble, was the word accuracy. Accuracy. So you're redoing this one, working on your pronunciation just a little bit more.
Due to the convenience and accuracy, I'd rather watch the news on TV or get it by using my computer than reading in the newspapers. Due to the convenience and accuracy, I'd rather watch the news on TV or get it by using my computer.
So the word get it and get it by using, there was a little bit of pronunciation problems with that, and get it.
Reading in the newspapers. First of all, watching the news on TV
or
get it by using my computer is very convenient.
Okay, let's go back.
Newspapers. First of all, watching the news on TV.
Okay, TV, pronounce the T with a little bit more air. Be careful about that sound, because if you don't, Adriana, it can almost sound like a D consonant sound, and you don't want it to sound like a different sound.
Or get it by using my computer is very convenient. For instance, after a long day of work, I really enjoy relaxing on my comfortable sofa in the living room and at the same time being informed. Second of all, I prefer to get the news by using my computer while watching television because this story...
Okay, wait a minute. Let me go back to try to follow this
prefer
idea.
Prefer to get the news by using my computer while watching television because this...
I'm having trouble how those two are
second
connected.
Second of all, I prefer to get the news by using my computer while watching television.
Using my computer while watching television, I'm not exactly sure what you're saying right there.
Because these two resources of information are...
This two or these two? I think there's some problems grammatical here.
...while watching television, because these two resources of information...
You want to say these two resources. Resources. Three syllables there. These two resources of information...
...are more accurate. On the other...
And good pronunciation of the word accurate there.
On the other hand, the printed news, it takes so long to be...
Be careful. The printed news, it. No. Your subject is the printed news. The printed news takes. You don't want to say the printed news, it. So be careful. That's a grammatical issue. You don't want to unnecessarily repeat the subject of your sentence.
News that sometimes the information could have happened or could have changed minutes after the newspaper was delivered.
Okay, so I think that's... You have a pretty organized speech there, but as I was pointing out, there are some grammatical issues and some delivery issues in the speech that make it a little bit tough. So I think your topic development on this speech was strong along with your examples. You're a little bit weaker in the language and the delivery areas. So I could see you on this one possibly scoring around 22 points, 2.83 out of 4, so 22 points out of 30 on this one based on my analysis of what you just did. And I think that's it. Let me double check one more time. I think I got them all. Okay, perfect. So, during this particular video, you talked to me a little bit about your most recent TOEFL score and your determination to keep going. I admire you for your hard work. And you also completed 4 different speaking practice tests, and I just gave you some feedback and scores on each of those. And keep up the good work.